Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, I thought that I would do another crazy ex-roommate story time. I actually did one of these before for a different situation that I went through in my life, and you guys really seemed to like that video. I'll link it down below for those of you who haven't seen it. I actually had a lot of very judgmental, very hateful comments on that video. So before I get into this video, I just wanted to say that I think that no one should be judging anyone, especially if they never were in that situation themselves. There's just no way that you can really judge or say what you would have done unless you were in that situation. That being said, this video is purely for entertainment purposes. I'm not really looking for anyone's advice. This story actually happened like 5 or 6 years ago now, so this is purely for your entertainment. So for some background information before we actually get into the scenario, my boyfriend and I moved to Portland, I think it was like 4.5 to 5 years ago. And when we moved to Portland, we actually first moved to a suburb, which was like about half an hour outside of Portland. And it was a very kind of like hoity-toity rich suburb. Basically, the reason that we were moving to Portland was so that I could go to a university outside of Portland called George Fox University. So we were actually moving in the summertime right before school was about to start, and I was actually supposed to be leaving for a trip to Europe because I was doing a summer abroad in Florence studying architecture. I really wanted to find a place before I left for the summer program because I didn't want to come home from that and then be like frantically searching for something. We actually ended up finding this place on Craigslist, and the living situation was basically a really big, pretty house in a really nice neighborhood in the summer of Tualatin. It was actually an elderly woman who lived in the house and owned the house, and her daughter was the landlord because she wasn't in the kind of health to really run a rental on her own. So her daughter was the one who was supposed to be taking care of everything. She was like the landlord. So we found a listing on Craigslist, called her, drove all the way from the Tri-Cities, which was about a 3-hour drive, to go see the house. I should have realized right away that something was like kind of off about her, but at the time I didn't really see it. I kind of had like my blinders on, I think. The house was very big, very pretty, so that was also a perk, I think. And the fact that it was like very affordable, it was like way under the budget of a lot of the other places we had seen online. And one of the really big things was that I was worried about is that I wanted to be able to hold the apartment but without having to pay for an entire month of rent. And she was willing to work with me on that. She basically was gonna have me put down like a very small deposit. We wouldn't have to pay for the month of rent that we wouldn't be living there. And when I got back from Europe, we would be able to move in. So that's kind of why we decided to go with this place. So basically we had some really weird roommates. There was a couple, one of them was actually a firefighter, and then her boyfriend, I think it was, I don't think they were married or anything, he, I don't know what he did, he had like a, like, I think he was like a geography major or something like that, but he didn't really seem to ever be working, so I don't really know exactly what he did. He was kind of always just home, and she was always gone doing firefighter stuff. Then the other guy that lived with us, he was in construction. And he was definitely a weird character. He was much older, and basically every time that we saw him, he would like engage us in some crazy conversation about his like paranoia theories. What are those called? Like conspiracy theories? He had a lot of those. So every time we'd see him, he would try to like engage us in some kind of conversation about conspiracies or whatever it was, political stuff. And it was very difficult trying to get out of the conversation with him without being like rude. So she lived downstairs in the master bedroom, and then the laundry and kitchen area was shared. There was a living room, but she was kind of always in there watching TV from her wheelchair. And then going up the stairs were the other bedrooms upstairs. So the couple had the bedroom at the end. The gentleman had the bedroom next to the bathroom, and then we had two bedrooms actually. One of them wasn't really a bedroom, it was like an extra like bonus type room, and that's where I like stored a lot of my stuff And then we had like the bedroom where we had just our bedroom stuff. And then the daughter, who was basically the landlord, she would show up like once a day. And it was always really awkward when I saw her, especially because she would never get my name right. She always wanted to call me, what was it? Esperanza. Rhonda. Like Esperanza, like she couldn't understand that was my name, so she would call me Rhonda instead, which was pretty annoying, but I didn't even bother to correct her. So after we've been living there for a few months, I actually looked her up because every single like encounter that I'd had with her was so strange. Like she never really seemed to understand what I was saying. She'd always kind of like go off on tangents and stuff like that. She was just like a really strange person. And then, so basically I looked her up, which I should have done before we even moved into the place. I also want to say, guys, like all of this could have been avoidable if we had just had more time to really evaluate and look at other apartments and not just like rush into an apartment. So this could have been avoidable if we hadn't rushed into this living situation. And I definitely recommend that you never rush into a living situation if you can avoid it. So I looked her up and found out so much about her, which was just crazy to me that you can so easily find out all this information. Like we found out that she'd gone through a nasty divorce, which isn't really relevant, but in that court case, it actually had listed that she had Asperger's and bipolar disorder, which definitely explained a lot of her like really strange erratic behavior. She would show up and clean things like in this really strange OCD way, and then she'd always be on our case. Like if we weren't cleaning up something, like if we were in the kitchen making our meals and stuff like that, she would kind of be like OCD and weird about that. Like it was just very uncomfortable, especially because we were supposed to be like sharing those areas. So she was just kind of like hard to deal with. And then the other thing that really sucked about living there was the fact that the older gentleman, the one who had like the paranoid theories and stuff like that, he would always, like I would catch him like spying on people. So like I said, like you could see the living room down below, and then you walked upstairs and that was like all open. So he would kind of like stand behind the railings upstairs and just stare down at people. Like we would be in the kitchen cooking and I'd look up and just see him like standing and staring at us down below in the kitchen. Or sometimes I'd like walk up the stairs around the corner and see him just there creeping, just staring at whoever was down there. And then I would also sometimes catch him standing outside of our bedroom. So like I said, like we had our bedroom and then the other two bedrooms were really close to our bedroom, and the bathroom was like across this way, and then his bedroom was next to the bathroom. So sometimes I'd come out of our bedroom to like go to the bathroom or whatever, and he would just be standing right outside of our bedroom. I don't know what he was doing. Like I said, he was spying on people. Maybe he was trying to like listen to us, like listen to our conversations, or like, I don't know what he was listening for. It was extremely inappropriate, and we definitely should have said something, but I didn't feel like I could really say anything because, like I said, we had found out that the landlord had Asperger's and bipolar disorder, so it was kind of like I didn't really feel comfortable talking to her about it. At the time, we kind of just thought, okay, we only have to be here for 6 months, and then after the 6 months are over, we'll get out of here and it'll be over with. The other couple, they were fine. The only thing that was weird that I would say about them was that they were really hard to talk to, not social, and they would like never really engage with us at all, which is fine. I mean, that's probably obviously better than the other guy. I had to take a break to charge the camera. And while I was taking my break, I wrote down a few more things that I remembered. So, one of the other things that was really annoying was that the older guy, he would come home like super late because he would work like late construction shifts and just get drunk. And then he would actually go into the bathroom, and I realized this later, that he would basically like piss on the floor because he would miss the toilet and it would get all over the floor. So whenever I'd go to the bathroom, it would always smell like absolutely disgusting, and none of the other roommates would help clean the bathroom. So I would literally get down on my hands and knees and scrub and clean because I just like can't stand the fact that it was like smelling and gross. Like I'm a clean freak, so I would get on my hands and knees and clean it, which is disgusting because at the time I didn't realize that he was like pissing all over the floor. I just kind of thought that our crazy landlord was using like some weird cleaning products because, like I said, she was like really OCD about cleaning, and she would use like really bad smelling products to clean. I don't know like what it was that she was using or what she was doing, but the place would always smell, and it would also always smell because she was supposed to be coming home and taking her mom potty. Like I said, her mom was in a wheelchair, very, very old, very fragile, like couldn't take care of herself. So she was supposed to be taking care of her and take her to the bathroom. But instead, she would always be gone. And there'd be times where the little old lady, her mom, would be like calling her, texting her, like desperately needing her to come and take her to the bathroom, and she just wouldn't. So she would have accidents. She would accidentally pee or poop in like the living room on the carpet, or sometimes like on the floor. So I'd come home from school, and a lot of the times the house would smell like pee or poop slash combined with the whatever cleaning products that the landlord lady was using. One of the times that I came home from school early, the little old lady was in the living room like screaming, hollering for help. So I went over to see what was wrong, and she said that she had to go to the bathroom, was super bad, but her daughter like wasn't answering her texts, wasn't answering her phone calls, and she was like absolutely desperate. So I told her that I could help her go to the bathroom. So I actually had to wheel her over to the bathroom down the hall, lift her up out of her wheelchair, and I'm not really like the strongest person, and she was surprisingly heavier than I thought. So lifted her out of that, down onto the toilet, helped her go poop, helped her wipe, like I had to wipe her, and then I had to lift her back up onto the wheelchair. And I'm not a professional, I don't know what I'm doing. Like at one point I almost even dropped her. I had to like use all of my strength to get her back into the wheelchair, washed her hands, took her back to the living room. And of course I was happy to do that because she was desperate and like needed to go to the bathroom so bad and it was an emergency. But I should have never been in that situation in the first place because I'm not a caretaker. Her daughter was supposed to be her caretaker. So that was just like a very frustrating, wild situation. And the landlord lady, she didn't like me for some reason. She was always very passive aggressive with me. Like I said, she had Asperger's and bipolar disorder, so she just was like very strange with me, but she had a crush on Skylar, so she would always be really nice to him and flirting with him, but just like mean to me. So I obviously like couldn't really complain or talk to her about any of these things. So back to the other roommates, like I had said, they didn't really talk to us or engage with us in any way, but one thing that they made clear when we first moved there is that the parking, the driveway, like the garage and the driveway were theirs. So they wanted those spots, they claimed them for their cars. So we actually had to park on the street, and we would get like in trouble. We'd get notes from our cars telling us to not park on the street, which was just ridiculous because that's where we lived. Like that was the only place we could park our cars, but they claimed like the driveway. So to kind of wrap this up, the landlord lady, the daughter, she no longer wanted to have to take care of her mom. She kind of wanted to get rid of her mom. She wanted to put her in a nursing home and sell her house so that she could have the money. So basically she super quickly put the house on the market. It sold really quickly. And she basically was like, you guys need to get out of here. Like, you have like 5 days or whatever it was, something crazy, to find a new place to live. So we had to like super quickly move out of there and ended up in another bad living situation because we had to find something so quickly. The reason that I even know this stuff about her wanting to like put her mom in a nursing home and sell the house and like the benefits of that, I know that because our other roommates basically had told us that. Like I had said, we were gone a lot of the time because we went to school and stuff. So I actually heard that information from them, but it was accurate because the old lady who actually owned the home, the mom, she confirmed that to me when I went down and talked to her before we moved. It was just a very sad scenario situation that we really had no idea about and couldn't really have known beforehand. I mean, I guess if I had like actually looked her up on the internet, I would have realized and learned that she had Asperger's, BPD and all that, but at the time I didn't know it, so it was kind of just this like crazy situation that we got ourselves into. We did actually go and visit the older lady in the nursing home a few times, but it was just a very sad situation, one of those really sad situations where like her daughter just, number one, didn't want to take care of her, and number two, like really wasn't capable of taking care of her because of her mental health. So that is it for this story time video. It was a very crazy situation, but I hope at least this video was entertaining to you guys. I've said it before and I will say it again, I have the craziest situations happened to me in my life. Like, I guess I just have like bad luck, or I don't know what it is, but I have so many crazy stories like this because I just go through some really crazy stuff in my life. If you guys like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you guys aren't subscribed already, please be sure to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.